Good morning. Today we are finally going to put together the pieces of our puzzle and make our first program. We're going to do a face milling of a step. So Paolo, let's not waste any time. I'm Paride, he's Paolo, and this is CNC, of course. The workpiece we are going to make is very simple and is a 300 by 200 plate with a lowered part 100 by 5mm in depth. We will start from a blank with a thickness of 32mm, so we will remove the 2mm of allowance during the face milling phase. Now let's see the two operations in detail. The first operation we will carry out is to face mill the entire plate using a 45 degree D.80 milling cutter, which we will call face mill 45 D.80. In this part of the course we will make a single pass to remove the 2mm, but then as we continue with the course, we will see the repetitions with the labels, and then we will learn to make several passes in depth. The second operation is the milling of the step, which is 100mm wide and 5mm deep. We will be using a square shouldering end mill, D63, which we will call square end mill D63. Again, we'll only do one pass for these first exercises, and later we'll learn to do repetitions when we see the labels. One last thing before we start, the work offset. As you can see from the diagram, we will position the G54 offset in the lower left corner, and in Z on the finished surface of the plate. So our blank in Z will have maximum Z coordinates of Z2 and minimum Z coordinates of minus 30. Well then, we can start. But wait a minute, I don't see Paolo. Paolo, where are you? Hey Paolo, what are you wearing? Where do you think you're going? We're on the simulator. We're not going on the real machine. And anyway, it seems excessive to dress like that. Well, let's forget about it and go to the simulator and start our program. As this is the first program we are creating in this course, we are going to create a folder which we will call CNC, of course, SIE02. SIE02 is the course code. If you have copied the entire Lesson 7 folder to the Cinetrain, then we will also move the Lesson 7 files. So select, cut, and insert into our folder. Now, always in our folder, let's create a new program. Click on the CNC of course folder and press New. Make sure that Program Guide Codes is selected. That is the ISO versions of Siemens. Enter the name of the file. I will put the course code followed by the lesson and then the exercise number. Well, click OK and our program opens. Now the first thing to do is to define the blank. That is, we have to tell the controller the shape and dimensions of our blank. This is only for the graphic simulation. To enter the blank, go to the Various menu and press Blank. The first thing to do is to select the shape type. Let's explain the shapes we have available. We can choose between a cylinder, a pipe, a centered parallel piped, a parallel piped, and finally a polygon, with a choice of the number of sides. In our case, we have to choose a parallel piped shape. The first is centered parallel piped, which is the case where the offset is exactly in the center of the workpiece. For all other cases in which it is not in the center, we will use the parallel piped shape. The parameters that the cycle will ask us for basically serve to define the coordinates of the two minimum and maximum coordinate points. X0 and Y0 define the coordinates of one of the four vertices from which we wish to begin defining our blank. X1 and Y1 define the coordinates of the second vertex. The coordinates of the first vertex, X0, Y0, do not necessarily have to be the vertex at the bottom left as shown in the figure, but can be any of the four vertices. The important thing is that X1 and Y1 is the vertex exactly opposite to X0, Y0. Then we have ZA, which defines the top coordinate of our blank along the Z-axis, and finally ZI, which defines the bottom coordinate of our blank along the Z-axis. The coordinates of X1, Y1, and ZI can be defined either in absolute or incremental mode. In incremental mode, this means that the coordinates will be referred to the first vertex, and in Z, they will be referred to ZA. To switch from incremental to absolute mode, simply press Select to switch the field, or click with the mouse on the field to be changed. Now we can enter the values for our figure. For the moment, we do this on the drawing of our workpiece. Then we go to the machine and compile the cycle. Let's choose the vertex to start from. I always define the vertex at the bottom left. So x0 will be 0, y0 will be 0. The opposite vertex, only for this case in which the offset is exactly on the first vertex, will have the same coordinates both in absolute and in incremental, and they will be x1 equal to 300 and y1 equal to 200. Let's move on to z. The initial value in z of our blank is 2, while the final value in absolute coordinates will be minus 30, in incremental coordinates, minus 32. Now let's go to the simulator and enter the data. Then we pick up where we left off and select parallel piped. If an error appears in red, don't worry because it is checking the parameters of x1 and y1 that we have not yet entered. We continue entering values for x1 and y1, so 300 and 200. Absolute or incremental in this case, there is no difference. We continue with ZA equal to 2 and enter ZI equal to minus 32 if it were incremental or minus 30 if it were absolute. Well, let's confirm this and see that a block is inserted which is exactly in the format of a fixed cycle. In fact, it is called workpiece, and in round brackets we find all the parameters we have just defined. Before starting the program, we write some comments to keep track of the part we are going to make. For example, a brief description of the machining and a brief description of the position. If you wish, you can write some of the text in lowercase, as in this case it is a note, to give it less importance. Well, let's start our program. So G17, G90, then call the G54 zero offset. Now we have to call the tool, but first let's create the tools. So we go to offset, pick an empty magazine place and create a new tool. In the operational course, we actually saw the exact procedure for loading tools into the magazine. In this case, being on a simulator, it is much simpler. So we put ourselves on the empty row and don't need to do the loading procedure in the magazine. Select the type of tool and it is already in the family of favorites. We choose facing tool. All face milling cutters fall into this type, whether they are at 45 degrees or other angles. We set the name face mill 45 D80. Set the example tool length to 100, the diameter to 80, and the number of cutting edges to 5. In the case of the face milling cutter, we have the option of also entering the external diameter of the cutter, which is usually around 94, while the angle is 45 degrees. We are already going to create the square shouldering end mill diameter 63 for the step, so we go to the next line, new tool. Since it is an end mill, we could choose the tool type 120 end mill, or 121 end mill corner rounding, since usually the insert, even if minimal, has a toric radius. In this case, we enter it as end mill, as it does not have a very high insert radius. Enter the name, so square end mill D63, a length and a diameter of 63, the number of cutting edges, and we are done. We can return to our program. Now enter the tool call, and we don't write the whole name of the tool ourselves, but use the very useful function found under the edit menu, which is select tool. We select our D.80 milling cutter and press OK. And M6 to perform the tool change. Now the technological blocks. So starting with D1 for the cutter, the S850 revolutions, the F600 feed rate, and we simultaneously start the spindle clockwise with M3. So we get to a safe distance Z of 300 to get close to the workpiece. And now we need to find the first point where we can start face milling. Performing face milling is an operation that seems very simple, but to do it well requires a minimum of calculations. Let's look at them together. We are going to make passes in the X direction. So first we need to calculate how many passes we need to make with our D80 cutter. Obviously we're not going to make 80mm passes and use 100% of the milling cutter, but we are going to use 75% of the milling cutter, which corresponds to an optimal use of 60mm. Now that we know that under optimal conditions the engagement of the milling cutter must be 60mm, let's find the number of lateral passes. So 200mm divided by 60 gives 3.3 periodic passes. But since the passes have to be an entire number, in this case we approximate to 3. And we go to recalculate the width of the side engagement for 3 passes. So 200 divided by 3, we have 66.66 periodic, say 66.6. So we'll make 3 passes of 66.6. Well, now we find the coordinates of the starting point, remembering that we're moving the center of the cutter. To make at least the first pass in concordance, we start from the x plus side, and to be exact in x, we'll take x 350 obtained as 300, the side of the workpiece, plus 10 safety outside the workpiece, and 40 the cutter radius. In y, the coordinate will be 66.6 minus 40, which is the radius of the cutter, so y 26.6. After the clearance position in z, we can move to the starting position. Also in this case with rapid feed, therefore g0, since we are far from the workpiece, coordinate x350 and y26.6. Now we can move down to z0. And in working feed, we can move to the opposite side of the workpiece to perform the first milling pass and exactly to x minus 50. Also in this case, obtained as 40 milling cutter radius plus 10 safety, but in negative direction along the x-axis. Well, now we can move on to the second pass by incrementing in y by 66.6. We could have used absolute coordinates, but it's easier to program incrementally. To do this, we use non-modal incremental programming. So y equals ic 66.6 in rapid because we are outside the workpiece. We make the pass in x, then exit to x350. And again increment in y, but this time at 66.6 we need to add at least 5 millimeters to get the cutter out of the workpiece a bit. We go back to x minus 50. And we come off at Z300, turning off the spindle with M5. Let's continue our program by milling the 100mm wide and 5mm deep step. In this case, it is very easy to do the math, because using a D63 milling cutter, its 75% is 47.5. So we will make two passes of 50mm, which will have coordinates Y100 and Y150, respectively. To these two values, we add 31.5, and this will be the Y position of the milling cutter center. We do this directly in the program. Reopen the simulator. We enter the tool call, then edit. Select tool, square end mill D63, confirm. M6, end of line, technology block, then D1, S1000, F1000, M3, G0, Z300. Now we move out of the workpiece and exactly to X minus 45, since the cutter radius is 31.5, plus another 10 of safety makes 41.5, so we set 45. Now Y, which we are going to calculate directly in the program, so Y equals 150, which is the coordinate of the first pass, plus the cutter radius, so 63, which is the diameter, divided by 2. Now we can move down in rapid traverse to the working Z coordinate, G0, Z-5. We go to make the first pass at X345 to exit the workpiece from the opposite side. We descend at rapid traverse to Y calculated as 100, which is the height of our wall, plus 63 divided by 2, which is the cutter radius. Then we go back to X-45. Then we move up in Z. Turn off the spindle and put M30 at the end of the program. Well, now before going to simulate, let's fix the program a bit, removing spaces where they are not needed and putting in some comments. Actually, let's make it better by putting groups, as we have already seen during the operational course. Groups are like chapters that contain parts of the program, making it more readable and organized. So we select the text part of the first tool and press Build Group. We enter a name for the group that helps us understand the tool and the operation. Now let's do the same thing with the D63 cutter. Well, now we can go and simulate. As soon as we open the simulation starts directly. We see that everything is fine. Now we put the graphics in 3D, orient our workpiece in the best way, and try again, but this time in single block. Now every start is a block. We see the descent to the safety position outside. The three passes of face milling. The tool change. And now the two passes with the square end mill D.63. Well, we've done the programme and probably some small improvements should be made, especially to manage the passes and possible finishes. This is just the beginning, and for those who are really beginners, I recommend doing the exercises combined with the lesson, which can be found by clicking on the file icon. It is really important that before going any further that you practice what you have seen so far. Even if everything seems clear to you, the only way to really learn is to sit down and make programs. Paolo, obviously this also applies to you. Don't think you can get away with it. We'll see you at the next lesson. Obviously, always here on CNC, of course.